Hi, this is the Randy B. from Tri-State Indy here at the Non Convention in Wilmington, Delaware, at the beautiful new Queen Theater, World Cafe Live, with local favorites, New Sweden. Welcome.
Hello.
How did that set feel? I mean, pretty rocking and great response. I mean, how did that feel for you guys?
It felt great. A lot of just getting it in there, you know, 20 minutes, so just do what we can, and we had a lot of fun, right? Everyone,
you know. Great time.
Cool. Yeah.
So you guys based here in Wilmington, and how long you been together? Is everybody like from this area as well?
No, not everyone.
Okay.
I'm from here. Jimmy and Zach. He's from Pittsburgh.
Okay. Gotta have a Pittsburgh guy in the band.
Oregon. That's
a, okay.
And we've been together for like a year and a half, I want to say.
Excellent. Really tight.
Yeah. Found these guys on Craigslist. So.
See. Thank God for modern technology.
Yeah.
You never know.
More than weird is.
So I hear you're recording your first record and releasing a single. Are you recording here in Wilmington, or what's going on with that?
You know, we're talking to a few individuals, and we can't drop any names right now.
Okay.
There's a lot of red tape going on, but we're going to record next month, and it should be out within 2 months.
Excellent.
So we're super excited about that.
Excellent. And are you doing some touring this summer, or?
Yes, we are. We are. We plan on just trying to attack the East Coast, go up and down as far as possible,
mm-hmm.
and wherever, you know, whoever wants to listen, we'll be there. So.
Sure.
What other venues do you play in the area?
I mean, pretty much every venue that's around this area we've played in. We've been
mm-hmm.
lucky enough. We're playing the Baby Grand on June 4th.
Okay.
Art and Guild.
We like to play at Mojo Main.
Yeah, Mojo Main, Mojo 13.
Right, okay.
We're playing here in July.
Philadelphia.
Yes, Philadelphia,
and
sure.
And right here in July.
Yes.
And right here again in July. What is the date in July for our people on watching?
July 29th, yes.
Excellent. Playing upstairs or down?
Downstairs.
Excellent.
Yes.
All
so
right.
we're super excited about that, too.
Great. So, Craigslist, how did you manage to find musicians of a like and simpatico, musical simpatico, the way you did?
Well, it started off.
Go ahead. Hey, you can hand
off, I don't know what Billy used to do in his free time, but apparently he used to surf MySpace for
okay.
musicians.
MySpace.
What's
what is
that?
MySpace?
I've heard
that was like from the 70s or 80s, right?
Yeah.
And we were doing like solo stuff, and he friended me or whatever.
Yeah, we dug
each other. Is that what it's called?
Yeah. Friend request. I don't know.
And then we got together.
Stalked him.
From there, we got together, and then after that.
Didn't your mom make you get together?
Yeah. Should we go into that?
Yeah.
Hey, moms are cool. Come
we
on.
Love moms, yes.
Anyway, well, that's my brother, so you can thank my mom for him.
Okay, there you go.
And, so then...
Mom made a drummer. You needed a drummer. Mom, help.
So we brought him on board, and then really quickly on Craigslist, we put out ads for...
what did we say?
A bass player and a cello player.
What do we put? Low Anthem, Avett Brothers, and Bright Eyes.
Right.
Yeah.
And we had another... The guy that actually... Caroline, very quickly, we were super lucky she came over and hit it off right away. And then Dan, we had an older gentleman that kind of, at the same time, right before him, asked to come over. And then all of a sudden,
older
Dan
as
called,
in?
Like 60.
Oh, 60. Yeah, that's kind of my age.
And
okay.
I'm not opposed to that, but it was kind of weird when I talked to him. So, luckily, he called. And then he came over, and I'm like, God, thank God. He's good looking. And
right.
I didn't know about this other guy, but yeah, it worked out to his first try, and every single one of us, like, it just clicked from the door.
Excellent. What I wonder about sometimes is the influences. I mean, you mentioned Avett Brothers, Bright Eyes, and, you know, but where does that come from? I mean, are you originally like a punk guy who got into the roots thing later on, or how do you, you know, where does it come from? That
yes.
Were you more classical, Carolyn? Let's hear from Carolyn a little bit.
All right, fine.
Okay.
My background is entirely classical. This
mm-hmm.
is the first thing I've ever done that's not classical.
Interesting.
So.
Yeah, your viola has a really nice wail to it. It does have a very, you know, I can tell you have a really good command of your instrument, but it's got a lot of soul going on there, too.
Yeah,
so.
There's really a combination of classical style and then folk style, something closer to fiddling that I get to do here, which
okay.
is really cool.
Yeah. Let me hear from the drummer for a sec. So, what's it like playing in a band with your brother? I mean, did you guys play in bands before?
No, it's my first band. I always looked up to him and just wanted to do what he does. And
wow, I'm ready to cry. That's like such a...
got me going.
Now we fight.
Yeah, now we work together. Probably going to live together soon. So. I don't know. I might fight a little bit.
Yeah. Excellent. Yeah. So, Bright Eyes, a big influence of Avett Brothers.
Yeah, it's kind of... It's kind of weird because I listen to like tons of different music. My father, growing up, everyone hates what your parents listen to until you get in your 20s and then you realize like they were right all along. So I've always enjoyed this style of music and I've wanted to play it, but I played in punk rock, hardcore, alternative, and finally landed with folk or Americana, whatever you want to call it, roots rock. I'm not sure what that means either. But it's exciting. So just to finally play something that you actually want to do, mm-hmm. as opposed to being in a band because you just want to play music.
Right.
So I'm pretty happy with it. Yes.
So anyway, you got gigs coming up this summer. The record should be out. Let's hear from Billy again.
The record is scheduled for July 29th, if the gods align and everything works
out. So tracks are done, or?
No. We actually, to make a long story short, we recorded some music, and then we weren't happy with how it turned out, because we did it ourselves, and we're trying to keep it DIY, but is that right, DIY? Do it yourself.
DUI would be the bad one.
Okay,
DIY
there you
is
go.
Fine. Yeah.
Anyways, and then someone approached us, and they really dug what we were doing, and he had a lot of contacts, which in the industry that, like, I wish I could tell you who it was, but
right, that's fine.
At any rate, they approached us, and they're, you know, we're still talking with them, but we're scheduled to start recording if everything works out next month, and we're gonna play it wherever we can play, you know.
Right.
New York, we have National Underground. When's that date?
It's coming soon.
No, okay, coming soon. The Tin Angel in Philly.
Great, okay.
North Star Bar, Philly.
Great.
I think Kung Fu, again. And then we have a bunch of Delaware shows we're trying to finish up. And then just keep pushing outside of, you know, our comfort zone and see what happens.
Excellent. Well, let me bring the little guy up here. Can
yes.
we have the interview? I mean, the future. Where did the name New Sweden come from? That was my...
Oh.
Jimmy, the historian.
Yeah.
Yes, please.
It is the first permanent colony in this area, so.
Okay.
But where did it come from?
Where did it come from?
Where did you find it?
Oh, on the Delaware .gov, like, history.
We wanted to bring some sort of relevance.
Yeah, isn't there some great, you ran into a Volvo on the road, something
no,
like
no.
that?
No.
It's a cool name, though.
It just represents where we're based out of, but instead of calling ourselves Wilmington.
A little bit of history. I mean, folk music derived from Sweden. If I'm pretty sure about that.
Well,
but,
Europe in general, I think.
Yeah.
But.
Well, no, a lot of what was it? What was it Folk Dana? We joked about that.
Yeah,
but
Folk Dana.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's pretty.
It just means I think it's Folk Dance.
Folk Dance.
Folk Dance. Yeah.
We are not Swedish.
It's a Folk Dance.
It's a cool name. It has some mystery to it, you know, and fits you guys. And again, the set was great. Look forward to the record and seeing you guys out on the road. This is the Randy B with Tri-State Indie. With the buzz on New Sweden here at the NOM convention in Wilmington.
Cool. Thank you.